Alright everyone, welcome back to Armored Core. I am SIMSteven, also known as Mr. Fenrel. And, well, before we get on with it, like usual, let's go to the garage, because I bought a couple parts off-screen. I bought this new head part, for one, because I got tired of pressing select to open the map and only seeing one room displayed on screen. So, yeah, I got one with some area memory. There are some out there with, I think, area memory plus names or locations or something like that. Not really necessary, but this head has all the functions that I need. Well, every function except for maybe that one thing where place and name or something. I don't know. But I got this head part. I don't think it's as strong defensively, but who cares? That's not why I buy head parts. Okay, in addition to that, I bought this one. Increases energy weapon power because I love my Kurosawa and I wanted to one-shot more things. Simple enough. So, what mission will we do today? If I remember right, this was, yep, chemical dyeing. They're part of Chrome, so I am going to ignore them. Earth Environment Reclamation Committee. I don't think they were in the best of reputation either, but we get some advance, some success, so let's... Well, and they're not chemical dyeing, so we're going to be doing this one. Several armed MTs have broken to a resource reclamation plant owned by the committee. Probably terrorists employed by those who want to distort our activities. Taking out several MTs, but with heavy damage, so we are asking for the Ravens for help. Close the gates within the plant to push them gradually into a large blast furnace at the center. We want you to pound, pound, pound them in there. Go fairy. naturally, the blast furnace is very hot. If you fall, your AC cannot survive. Make good use of the geography. Will be the key of the battle. Good luck. Okay, so it looks like a giant shaft of some sort. And looking closely at that green diagram, looks like there are catwalks all over the place. Because I see a little... lines going in the inside. So, looks like, well, six MTs, that doesn't sound too bad. Looks like you just need to, you know, watch where you land, I suppose, and don't run out of energy. Best I could probably say for this kind of mission. And if you fall all the way down, you're probably gonna die. So, without further ado, let's get on with this mission.
Main system engaging combat mode.
By the way, it has a new head part has a more refined voice, I suppose. I think the other ones were rough. I don't know. But now I have a sexy British lady doing my commentary, or my commentary.
Operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
Alright, for the sake of being funny, I killed the sixth one while I was above the lava, and I don't think that really did anything to my damages. So I guess, you got to see me burn. Burn to the ground. No, we're not doing flame high in art right now. Alright, so... back in the nest. Yeah, I kind of wanted to spend some money off screen because I had, what, 120,000 credits or so. And I hadn't spent money on anything, so a whole lot of good that map did in that one last stage, because I didn't really need it. There were just six targets, and they were all almost in a straight line, basically. Straight vertical line, that is. Anywho, that was pretty simple for mission. We're going to get to the next one in a sec after I finish saving the game. Like I say, I always save the game between each and every mission because I like to have my flawless win record as much as possible, except for the one I'm going to have to fail for that radar part where you, if you collect it, you'll fail the mission and all that. So yeah, I hate when they do that to you. And I guess we have no choice but to do this one mission for Chemical Dying. I think in the last episode, we were the ones responsible for releasing all these BOWs in the lab. Was that two episodes ago? I'm not entirely sure. Either way, we went into this lab and, well, we went in and opened up all their vats that they were producing these things in. Now the lab is overrun, and they're going to pay us to fix the problem. We started the problem, now we're going to fix it, and they're going to pay us twice. Yay for double dipping. someone has entered our lab and destroyed the test vat. The lab is now overflowing with biological weapons. The worst problem is the queen organisms are able to produce. And I cannot say that word right. Organisms. Upon leaving the test vat, the cell tissue becomes activated and begins reproducing in no time. If it has already begun reproducing, there may be an overwhelming number of them. Good thing I got my chain gun and my sawa. that's a lot of ammo on my side. So they are starting to try to break open the outside wall sooner or later and escape to the outside. Deal with the small types later, so your target is only the four queen organisms. Should bring down all the beasts. Okay, so we got four of these things, plus probably an endless swarm of them all throughout the lab. But anyways, I'm going to shut up, and we're going to go out and get on with this.
Main system engaging combat mode.
Raven, don't worry about the small ones. Aim for the big ones that are able to reproduce.
By the way, I should mention a couple things. Definitely want to have biosensors so you can target these guys. Otherwise, missiles and lock-ons will be completely useless and you have to manually aim at every single one of these things. Second, same problem as last time. When I slide down one of these slants, it just kind of lifts me off because the slant is too steep and it doesn't properly slide down the ramp like it's supposed to. And I thought I had something else I was going to say, but oh well. Oh yeah, they were saying, don't worry about the small ones. I wonder if they're going to pay me a bonus or not if I kill the small ones as I go. So, for as long as I have laser rifle shots, my Saba, I'm going to keep killing them as I go. Alright, and here we go.
Yeah.
One of the big ones might be over there. Be careful.
Target of operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
All right. Oh, wow. That's a pretty huge special edition. So, yes, I was thinking about this right. Oftentimes, they don't really tell you this, and it's kind of odd that I'm bringing it up now. But, yeah, sometimes they frequently don't tell you when, if you kill more enemies, you get a bigger reward, and that'll add to your, you know, your bonus, so to speak. So I kind of wanted to just go exploring, because I heard that third one, there was like that trap door down one of the tunnels, and I heard one, I could tell by the sound effects that there was a big one down that hole, but I never really explored that level, I don't think ever before. And I'm kind of glad I did, because when I did go exploring, I saw all those weird rooms with the giant glass panels. I don't ever remember seeing those, excuse me, before. Burp, I just ate lunch, so a bit of gas there. but speaking of which, we got, I guess not speaking of which, either way, ignoring that, yeah, we kind of got through that mission, and I definitely wanted to just kind of look around that place a little bit more, because I don't think that that whole map area gets a whole lot of use throughout all the missions in the game, so that's kind of one reason why I want to do it. Alright, oh, this mission. I know this mission by name because it apparently has a part in it. Hold on one second. I am going to take a look at my own guide that I made and see what I have to do to get the part in this. One sec. 1 second is up because of editing magic. apparently, I just have to go in the ceiling on the south end of the main chamber. Easy enough, I suppose. Alright, so, Murakumo. I'm glad it worked for you guys once again. We just got a terrifying communique from the Terrace Grove group. Imminent storm. They said that they are occupying the air cleaner above Isaac City. This unit takes air from above ground, cleans it, and sends it down to the underground city. It's literally the city's lifeline. Their demands are for the immediate dismantling of Murakumo, who they say have become a ringleader of social decay. Their false accusations are brash. Their recent activities have been a string of failures thanks to you, Ravens. This is a desperate act of desperate men willing to die with honor. With honor? After killing tons and tons of innocent people by essentially cutting off their air supply? I don't consider that honorable. Not in the least. Eliminate them quickly. Note that the air cleaner is an extremely complex structure due to repeated retrofits of the expansion of the underground city. Be careful. Blah, 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 blah. Alright, we're gonna get started, and once again, I'm gonna shut up, and hopefully there's music in this one. Hopefully.
Main system engaging combat mode.
Containing poison gas. Just in case, we will halt the fans. We have stopped the fans. We can only stop them for 10 minutes. Find that tank quickly.
AC weapon obtained.
Okay.
Tank recovered. Target of operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
Ay, 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 talk about a maze. Oh, wow. I think I must have gone in every path except the one I was supposed to until the very end. And by the way, I did already fail this mission once already. I completely forgot how I got there, but apparently when I got to that room with the poison tank, I didn't even see it because I was having a troublesome time turning around and the enemy destroyed the tank and blew it up, and that's how I failed the mission the first time around. So at least the very beginning went smoothly when I got the AC part, and it looked like a double shoulder missile or something. So we're going to take a look at that real quick. Alright. Got mail. We'll look at that quick in a minute too. So, back weapons. I assume this is a double shoulder part. Yes, it is. And it's a missile. Maximum lock. Okay, so I think I kind of know what that does. I think it shoots like 8 or 12 missiles at a time or something like that. It probably would have said it in the description, but when you equip it, both shoulder weapons use it at the same time. So essentially, you're sacrificing one weapon slot for a very powerful weapon. Similar to, you know, if you equip those weird arms that don't allow you to equip a blade instead. Anyways, Imminent Storm has been destroyed. They clearly went too far. Even Chrome could not stop the backlash against them. And eventually, Chrome will be destroyed as well. But this process was necessary for our rebirth and that of all humanity. That's kind of weird. R is sounding kind of villainous all of a sudden, even though, well, obviously we don't know who he is. He's just our contact within the Raven's Nest. But, I don't know. We're going to save the game, and we're going to take a look at the next mission real quick. And I'm at about 40 minutes recording on the dot because I failed that mission once. I don't know. I'm going to probably cut that failed attempt out simply because I was wandering around pretty much like in the whole deal there where I was kind of running around. And half the time I couldn't see where I was going because I was trying to follow the pathway and my turning speed was so slow I couldn't really go and point the camera forward. Gotta wait for Armored Core 2 when they give us extension equipment. Then I'll have like the turn boosters and stuff like that. Actually, I don't think that's until another age, but oh well. Chrome Uprising. Alright, so we're going to be destroying Chrome, it looks like here. Chrome have finally started an armed uprising socially. They had been in a cornered position. Seems they have finally made their move. We wish no unnecessary fighting. But their mere presence is a danger to all of humanity. You don't crush the bad seeds of Riddick will again begin to spread. Justice is ours. Our elite troops have come under the attack of in various regions. The war situation is going just as we had expected. However, we miscalculated. We had to fight pitched battles against Chrome detachments appearing above ground. Civil military bases were attacked and suffered crippling blows. According to reports, the enemy is a small detachment of 5-6 MTs, but their capabilities cannot be taken lightly. They are probably Chrome's latest mounts. The enemy's attack vectors. Their next target is probably a military base in the Zam Desert. I want you to head to the base ASAP and engage the enemy in detachments. Alright, looks like an arena that comes in the next game, but for now, though, actually, this looks like the Industrial Park Arena or whatever that's called. One of my favorites from both Project Phantasma and Armored Core 2, if I remember right. But either way, we're going to go into this. Actually, wait a second here. I am going to back out real quick and I kind of want to buy a new part. Even though we got a new one, I think our missile has, well, it really hasn't been used a whole lot. And I've been deliberating on when I should buy this, but it looks like since things are starting to get a lot more serious, I want to buy the plasma cannon, this one here. Since I already have that optional part that I bought before the start of this episode, this was also part of my plan. I just didn't have enough money at the start of the episode to buy this as well. And no, I am not ignoring my blade arm. Well, actually, I kind of am, but beside the point, I'm waiting for a specific mission because I typically don't upgrade my blade arm until a specific mission comes around. And I don't even know if I'm able to get that before I beat the game, because if we're destroying Chrome right now, then I'm wondering if I skip the mission where we get the moon blade or moonbeam blade, the one where we destroy imminent storm, and or the struggle. No, we're supposed to destroy the struggle leader, which I think we just destroyed imminent storm. And the mission that I'm looking for is destroy the struggle leader, which has the moonbeam blade. But I still haven't seen that yet, and maybe it's after this one. Maybe we'll get the war against Chrome started up a little bit more. I don't know, but beside the point, hopefully we'll get that mission sooner or later. But for now, we're going to just go and do this mission. Sorry for backing out too quickly and changing my mind, but yeah, I find myself not using my missile launchers whatsoever, so an upgrade is necessary, I suppose. Let's go!
Main system engaging combat mode. Target of operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
That was a lot more intense than I was expecting. That felt like I was fighting three different ACs, to be honest. I think it was those Chaos Unit MTs or whatever they were that we did in those test missions a couple episodes back. Actually, more than one episode back, but it was more than one episode that we fought those things. But yeah, I think we ended up fighting three of those. And I really legitimately felt like I was fighting another AC. But I guess not. Well, at least when that first welcome, when we fought one right off the bat. And I ended up using up a lot of ammo because I was flying around looking for one and I was out of energy. Anyway, we're going to mop up the chrome remnants. Alright, special report for all Ravens. It's been decided to disband the chrome group that planned a military coup d'etat using the new robotic weapons. Kuma Millennium will control and inspect the remaining assets of chrome so that they can be reused. Oh, so they're taking all their weapons for themselves. Now the confrontation is over, there may be less and less for you Ravens to do. Hopefully this sign will make a move toward a peaceful future. It's not over yet, we have a job for you. We need to survey the Chrome military base. Some remnants of the group may still resist, but their strength is inconsequential. We want you to check out the situation in the interior of the base and mop up any resistance you find there. Pay should be adequate. Theater operations. Alright. Before we get started here, I just want to get something off my mind here for a sec. We're getting into this final war between Murakumo and Chrome. And obviously we sided with Murakumo this time around because we did more of their missions than Chrome's. But overall, I just want to say that we kind of touched upon the subject of the Great Destruction before, or whatever it's supposed to be called. That whole Great Destruction that forced all of humanity underground, you know, that thing, well, that was caused by two corporations at war, similar to how Murakumo and Chrome are fighting each other right now. And I think history is kind of repeating itself because the Great Destruction essentially was a nuclear war at the very end, and all the radiation made the surface of the Earth uninhabitable. At least I think it was. It's something along those lines. It essentially destroyed the surface of the Earth, and all of humanity was forced to move down into the subterranean tunnels, which is primarily where the game takes place and all that. But anyways, yeah, history is kind of repeating itself, as well as right now, where I am going to repeat myself by shutting up and letting you listen to the music and all that. So, we got another mission to mop up the Chrome remnants.
We've arrived at the combat area. We'll leave as soon as your AC is deployed.
Main system engaging combat mode.
Thank you.
Okay, I remember this. at first, I didn't even remember what this mission was about until I saw the walls. Now, I don't remember hardly any of the missions that I've been playing as I do this whole Let's Play. A lot of it's just been, you know, completely by reflex. But this mission, I remember quite well. Now that I've been through all those rooms. Those rooms that we've been through have essentially been there to whittle down your ammo and your hit points. Because when you come out of this little... this doorway here, if I'm not mistaken, we're going to be attacked by something big. And if not, then I'm going to be completely wrong on this. But I'm pretty sure this is that mission. It's a kind of a special mission, because you have a bit of a special fight. But let's go.
Raven, help me! Monster!
High energy response found. Cannot identify. Insufficient data. Operation cleared. System switched to normal mode.
Yep, I was right. And as that aircraft pilot or that helicopter pilot said, it's a monster! A monstrously disappointing AC. Oh, cutscene.
The struggle for market share between Murakumo and the up-and-coming Verge Company is becoming more and more intense. Future developments look interesting.
So, nothing has changed after all.
Okay, so we're coming down to the end, if you couldn't tell by that cutscene. First, though, let me get what was off on my mind before that cutscene interrupted me. Yeah, even though that giant, I think it was an AC, it might have been an AC, or it could have been an MT, just extremely, extremely big. Yeah, I pretty much, the best advice I have is get your best weapon, like my plasma cannon, and hold down the square button. Pretty much lock on and don't let up with your firepower. He doesn't have a ton of hit points, and he can devastate you quickly if you just don't move. But if you are pretty well prepared, which at this point you should be, yeah, you'll be able to clear out that mission pretty quickly and defeat that boss relatively easily, as long as you just stay on the move, circle, and strafe. Yeah, Mega Man Legends tactics once again save the day. For now, though, I am going to check the optional parts. And I'm going to buy this since I got space and all that. I have enough money to buy both of these optional parts as well. Both damage reducers. So, I'm probably going to just slap those on. And I am still not seeing the mission where we kill the struggle leader. I'm probably going to be going into the last mission without my moonbeam, which I think is going to be a first, unless we get that after the next mission. I'm not entirely sure. But yeah, we're coming down to the end, pretty much. I'm going to beef up my energy weapons first. Okay, so I can equip all those, and I still have 4 slots left. So, by the way, can I equip that other core? No, I didn't even buy it. Okay, I thought I had bought the other core that has more optional slots on it, but I guess not. So anyways, oh yeah, that's right, because there was a problem with the core weight or something on that. I don't remember entirely, but it was something along those lines. But anyways, I've been going for just over an hour, that one mission attempt that I cut out. So, getting down to the end from the looks of things. And next time, we'll be going to mop up more chrome remnants. Okay. Oh, it's the Raven's Nest doing the requesting. Okay, so this is a different mission. I thought this was the exact same mission there for a second. I know that's not the final mission of the game before you, you know, unlock the whole new game plus and are able to do any mission you please. But I'm pretty sure that's one of the few before it. So next time you might expect to see the end of the game, and then we'll go back and start mopping up some incomplete missions. And are we still at the... Okay, we still have one guy up above us. Hustler 1, number 1 Raven, said to be the strongest ever, has a reputation of always handling the tough jobs. I get the feeling pretty soon we're going to be facing him in one-on-one combat. So we'd better hustle on there. Yeah, I get it. Lame joke. But yeah, we're done here. We're ending the episode. So I'm just going to say thanks for watching, and I hope to see you again next time.